Well, praise the Lord. My name's Bishop Kepha, Omae, the presiding bishop of the Redeemed Gospel Church and the senior pastor of Liberty Christian Center that is located along Mombasa Road within Plainsview. It's a great joy to have you in this morning program, Command Your Morning. I want to thank God so much that he has made it possible for us to be together, even to share God's word. I believe that as we go through God's word this morning, your spirit is going to be ignited, it's going to be inspired, it's going to be stimulated, and at the same time, I believe God is going to do a new thing in your life, even as you prepare yourself today to face the joys and the challenges of this day. But before we do so, I want us to pray and then get into a moment of worship and then get to the word of God. Shall we pray? Loving Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you for this day, the day that you have made. We rejoice and we are glad in you. Thank you, Father, because of the great plans that you have for each one of us. Lord, I trust in you today for a supernatural work in the lives of your people that have joined me this morning in this program, Command Your Morning. I pray, dear Father, that you bless our worship and the ministry of your word this morning. We declare by the word of the Lord that our lives will not remain the same. Holy Spirit, we invite you even into this program right now. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. We are going to read from the book of Numbers, Numbers chapter 13. We read from verse number 1. The word of God declares, "And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Send men to spy out the land of Canaan, which I am giving to the children of Israel. From each tribe of their fathers, you shall send a man, everyone a leader among them." Verse 17. Then Moses sent to spy out the land of Canaan and said to them, "Go up this way into the south and go up to the mountains and see what the land is like, whether the people who dwell in it are strong or weak, few or many, whether the land they dwell in is good or bad, whether the cities they inhabit are like camps or strongholds, whether the land is rich or poor, and whether there are forests there or not. Be of good courage and bring some of the fruit of the land." Now the time was the season of the first ripe grapes. We go down to verse number 27. Then they told him and said, "We went to the land where you sent us. It truly flows with milk and honey, and this is its fruit. Nevertheless, the people who dwell in the land are strong. The cities are fortified and very large. Moreover, we saw the descendants of Anakim there. The Amalekites dwell in the land of the south. The Hittites, the Jebusites, the Amorites dwell in the mountains. And the Canaanites dwell by the sea and along the banks of the Jordan." Then Caleb quieted or silenced the people before Moses and said, "Let us go up at once and take possession of the land, for we are well able to overcome it." Praise the Lord. But the men who had gone up with him said, "We are not able to go up against the people, for they are stronger than we." And they gave the children of Israel a bad report of the land which they had spied out, saying, "The land through which we have gone as spies is a land that devours its inhabitants, and all the people whom we saw in it are men of great stature. There we saw the giants, the descendants of Anak came from the giants, and we were like grasshoppers in our own sight, and so we were in their sight." Ladies and gentlemen, dear viewers, people of God, when you go through the book of Numbers and chapter 13, there are things that clearly feature and thoughts that I would want to share with you from the word of God. I would like to draw your attention to this famous story or episode, as we call it, from these portions of scriptures that we have read, as found from the book of Numbers chapter 13. Point number one we need to understand from this chapter is that God had already promised the people of God, the children of Israel, the land. He had already given them a promise. He had spoken to Abraham as recorded in Genesis chapter 15. You read from verse number 1. You go all the way to chapter 16, chapter 17, and even previously, before you get to chapter 15, you begin from Genesis chapter 12. You see God entering into a covenant with Abraham. And he spoke to Abraham and told Abraham that he will bless him and become a father of many nations. And then apart from that, God speaks to Abraham and tells him that his seed, his descendants, will inherit a land of their own. Now, this is a land that the servant of God is sending the spies to go and scout out, spy out, check out, and find out how the land is, how it looks like, so that they could bring back a report to him and the children of Israel. Now, the word of God declares that even as they had gone out and spied the land, and they scouted the land, they came back with a report. The word of God declares that they came even with a fruit from the land. And as they began to report, we see the first group beginning with a very encouraging report. They said, for sure the land that you sent us to go and spy, Moses, is a good lookly, is a good looking land. It's a fertile land. It's a land that flows with milk and honey. They began with a good report. And as they were reporting, Moses' heart was excited. The children of Israel were excited because indeed they had confirmed what God had said and what they knew God had spoken to Abraham about concerning the land, that indeed the land was fertile and the land flowed with milk and honey. It was a goodly looking land. But as they were reporting, giving that encouraging report, they watered it down by using the word but. They said, but the land, apart from the land being good, there's something that we saw in the land. We saw giants in the land. That report watered down the first report. That report which they brought after giving an encouraging report, the second report melted the hearts of the children of Israel. The Bible says, they said that we saw the giants in the land from the tribe of Anakim, and that's where Goliath came from. Indeed, there were giants. And then apart from that, they said, hey, we also heard that the people of the land eat people. And as we saw ourselves before them, we seemed like grasshoppers. Now, as they were reporting that, as they were adding that negative report to the first positive report, what happened? The people began to cry. Their hearts melted out. They'd begun with a good report. They'd begun with an encouraging report. They'd begun with a wonderful testimony, a positive report concerning the land. But when they changed the story and said that they'd seen the giants in the land and they looked like grasshoppers before the giants and they heard of how the people in the land eat people, their hearts melted and that watered down the report. People of God, I want to share with you this morning on a very simple message from these portions of scripture. Whose report will you believe today? You have woken up this morning and you are preparing yourself even to face the joys and face the challenges of the day. I want to remind you and bring to your attention that even as you begin your day today, there is a possibility that you will begin to hear all kinds of reports. You'll begin to hear encouraging reports. You'll begin to hear encouraging testimonies. You are going to meet with people at the marketplace, wherever you are going today. And there is a possibility there will be that person that will come with a discouraging report to wanting to water down what God has already promised you, what you know God has assured you of, what God has said he will do for you. And I want to caution you this morning, child of God, that even as you prepare yourself to face this day, as you go to your working place, even as you go to the marketplace, as you go to your office, as you begin to interact with friends out there, be careful as to which report you are going to listen to. Because the Bible says that there are many voices out there, and all these voices have got some significances. I want to encourage you, my brother, my sister, dear viewers, that even as you begin this day, as it is the title of this program, that we command our morning, that you will draw your mind and your attention to the Word of God and what God has promised you. I want to encourage you, dear viewers, that there are so many voices that are out there. As you go to your workplace, as I've said, there will be all manner of voices that you will begin to hear. But I want to encourage you today, please purpose in your heart as a child of God to listen to that which will edify you, that which will build you. We need to understand that God has already promised us of things that he will do for us. God has already spoken in his word concerning his plans, his thoughts that he has concerning our lives. I want to encourage you, my friend, God has great plans for your life. God thinks well of you. God thinks well of you. God has great plans for your life. That devil is a liar. In case somebody comes up and begins to speak negativities into your hearing, it begins to speak things that you don't need to hear, or wanting to contravene the word of God, wanting to contravene the promises of God concerning your life, just simply stand up like Caleb and Joshua and say, no, I will not take that, because God says that I am blessed and I'm not cursed. God says I'm above and not beneath. I want to encourage you, my brother, my sister, even as you face this day today, just face it with the word of God. Face it with these promises that God has given us concerning our lives. Stand up like Caleb and Joshua and say, we are well able to take the land. Where did they get that strength and courage from? They got that strength and courage from what God had said. They knew God had promised Abraham that his seed would inherit a land of their own. God had repeatedly spoken to Abraham, as I indicated in Genesis chapter 12, chapter 13. You go all the way to chapter 15. God had kept on assuring Abraham that his seed, his posterity, will inherit a land of their own. Now, Caleb and Joshua knew what God had said. Do you know what God has said about you? Do you know the promises of God concerning your life? Do you know the promises that God has given you as his child? You need to stand on the word of God and not on other voices, not on negativities, not on people's opinions, not on what people say about you. I want to encourage you this morning, line up your thinking with God's word. Purpose in your heart to take God at his word, because what God has said concerning you is final. All else is sinking sand. Whatever people say about you are just but opinions, but what God has said about you is final. It's the absolute. I want to encourage you, just like Caleb and Joshua stood up when these people began to say, hey, apart from the looking good, being fertile, flowing with milk and honey, we saw the giants in the land. Yes, as you face this day, there will be giants in the land. There will be giants that will be at the marketplace. There will be giants that will be out there wherever you will go today. But you need to see opportunities beyond those challenges. You need to see God at work even in those moments and in those situations that you might find yourself in today. Stand out like Caleb and Joshua. Stand out like Caleb and Joshua and say, our God and my God is well able to see me through. Now, when Caleb and Joshua stood up and quieted and those people gave the first report, the Bible declares that there was great joy, of course, because Caleb and Joshua encouraged the hearts of men and women that had heard a discouraging report. Now, I want you to understand that in this world, my brother and my sister, dear viewers, in this world, we've got all manner of voices. Not all voices come to encourage you. Not all voices come to build you up. Not all voices come to add value into your life. You've got to make up your mind. The decision is yours. You've got to make up your mind to take the word of God with you, to stand on the promises of God, to stand on what God has said, like Caleb and Joshua, so that whatever the enemy may have planned or whatever somebody might have planned against you, against your destiny, will be diffused and will be brought to nothing. Caleb and Joshua purposed in their hearts to stand on God's word. They purposed in their hearts not to line up their thinking and not to join the other group that were full of negativities. I want to encourage you, my brother, my sister, dear viewers this morning, that even as you go out of your house today, as you go to your office, as you go to the marketplace, wherever you work, that you go with the same spirit that Caleb and Joshua had. Stand on the word of God. Stand on the promises of God. And know that God is faithful. I want to encourage you. Our God is faithful to his word. Whatever he has promised in his word is yeah and amen. God is not a son of man that he should lie. Now, I want to encourage you. There are many things that God has assured you of. There are many promises that God has given you. Some of you that are watching this morning, this program, I've heard over and over again, either through a man of God, a woman of God, a pastor, a preacher, or you have heard a prophetic word declared over your life. I want to encourage you this morning, shut your ears from listening to negative reports. Shut your ears from listening to any report that will bring in the spirit of doubt and unbelief in your heart, and take God at his word, because he is faithful. God's nature speaks of his faithfulness. He is a faithful God who answers prayers. He's a faithful God who stands by his word. I'm reminded of a couple of scriptures by viewers this morning that reminds us about the faithfulness of God. The Bible says that God is faithful. Who will also do it? God is faithful that he will watch over his word to perform what he has said concerning our lives. I want to encourage you, wherever you are, maybe some of you are in the hospital bed right now. You've gotten up this morning and you're watching this program while in that pain, while in that situation, while in that condition. I want to assure you this morning, God has not changed his mind concerning you. God has not changed his mind. His plans concerning your life. I want to encourage you, dear viewer. I want to encourage you, my brother, my sister. It doesn't matter where you are right now and in whichever situation you are, God is faithful. He stands by his word. He watches over his word to perform what he has said. The word of God that we read, the Bible that we read, is full of God's promises. It's full of God's assurance concerning the plans and the thoughts that he has for our lives. And therefore, if God has assured us of the things that he will do, if God has given you a promise concerning what he will do for you, what he will do for your family, what he will do in your marriage, what he will do in your business, what he will do in your career, what he will do in your own personal life. Maybe you are watching this program and you are sick in your body. You have pain and discomfort within your systems. I want to encourage you, my brother, my sister, God has not changed his mind concerning your healing. For the word of God says he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Circumstances don't change God. God changes circumstances. I come to you this morning with the word of God. I come with a prophetic declaration in your life that is a matter of time. And God is going to show himself mighty on your behalf. God is around your situation, and you will stand out with a testimony that indeed he is a faithful God. I came to you this morning with this word of encouragement that it does not matter what kind of reports you have heard, it the kind of voices you are hearing from friends out there at your place of work. God has a final word concerning your life, and God was assured you, God was assured us of his plans and thoughts concerning our lives will stand by his word. The Bible says, heaven and earth will pass away, but the word of the Lord will stand sure. Hallelujah. God will stand by his word. He will honor his word. He will fulfill his promises concerning your life. Now look at this wonderful story that even after Caleb and Joshua had stood up, God never changed his mind. When these other spies gave out a negative report, that did not change God's mind. At the end of the day, what do we see? We see the children of Israel inheriting the land of promise. I came to encourage you, my brother, my sister. We are living in a world that is full of challenges. We are living in a world that has got so many voices. We are living in a world that has got too much. This today, you hear that tomorrow. We get affected by this situation. We get affected by that situation. Yes, that's the kind of a world we are living in. But I came to tell you, That doesn't change God's nature. That doesn't change God's mind. That doesn't change God's thoughts concerning our lives. I want to assure you today, God has not changed his mind concerning your life. God has not changed his mind concerning your destiny. It's only yourself who can decide to change the plan of God by rebelling against him, disobeying him, and walking away from him. If you disobey God, you walk away from God, you live a rebellious life, then there are consequences that follow. And I want to say that many people are suffering because of disobedience to God's word. They're suffering because they have chosen to listen to other voices and turn to other ways instead of turning to God and turning to his word. I am here as a testimony to encourage you, my brother, my sister, that when you remain faithful to God's word, when you remain faithful to God, when you stand on the solid word of God, no wonder the singer sang and said, standing on the promises of God. If you stand on the promises of God, you stand on the word of God, you stand on what God has said, you will see the supernatural hand demonstrated in your life, and whatever you are going through today shall become a testimony for you. I want to pray with you this morning that even as you face whatever circumstance it is today, you will stand on the promises of God. You will stand on the word of God. You will shut your ears from listening to other voices and listen only to the voice of God. Before I pray, dear child of God, you could be listening to this program. You are watching this program wherever you are, and you have never given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. I want to let you know the greatest gift and miracle that you can receive and have in your personal life is to welcome Jesus Christ into your life, into your heart as your Savior. Please, if you have not given your life to Jesus and you're saying, "Preacher, pray for me. I want to surrender my life to the Lord." Please pray this prayer after me. Say this after me. Dear Lord Jesus, I come to you this morning. I am a sinner. I repent of all my sins. And I ask you, Lord, to forgive me. Cleanse me with your precious blood. Write my name in the book of life. I believe in my heart. My sins are now forgiven. My name is written in the book of life. Thank you, Father, for accepting me as your child. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Congratulations. If you have prayed that prayer, believe in your heart that your sins have been forgiven and your name is now written in the book of life. Please make up your mind from today to join a Bible-believing church that teaches the word of God. Search for a pastor that will mentor you and disciple you in the things of God so that you can grow in the faith. Loving Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for speaking to us this morning that you cannot be changed, you cannot be moved by circumstances. Father, I pray that you'll help each one of us that have heard your word this morning to stand on your promises, to stand on your word, and believe your report, believe your promises, believe what you have said, and not any other report. We shall only believe your report. Lord, I thank you for my viewers this morning. I pray that even as we embark on the activities of the day, Lord, as we go to the marketplaces, wherever we work, in the sphere of our own influences, that, Lord, your word shall have a place, the central place in our hearts. And more so, Lord, we shall not be moved and be shaken by the things around us. We shall not be shaken or be moved by the kind of voices we will hear that will water down your word. We shall stand on your word because your word is yeah and amen. It's forever established in heaven. Your promises, oh God, are yeah and amen. So, Father, we give you praise and we thank you as we command this morning to line up with the word of God. We give you all the praise in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. I wish you a blessed, prosperous, and glorious day. Once again, my name is Bishop Kepha Omae, the presiding bishop of the Redeemed Gospel Church and the senior pastor of Liberty Christian Center in Plainsview along Mombasa Road. You are blessed, and the devil can do nothing about it.